Kellie Gerardi is training for the mission of her life.
We are getting suited up and we're going to go on EVA, extravehicular activity.
There's the suit, the headgear, even a trip through an airlock.
This is EVA 149-5, cycling down.
Kellie is no astronaut, but she's come here to the rocky plains of remote Utah to spend 3 weeks at the Mars Society's Desert Research Center.
That's an incredible environment out here. It really feels like Mars.
It may seem a bit extreme, but this Florida native hopes it will give her an added edge over thousands of other applicants, all vying for a trip to Mars. But there is one massive catch. It's a one-way ticket. It's the audacious idea from a new company called Mars One, which says 200,000 ordinary humans from around the globe applied to leave life on Earth behind. Like Kellie Gerardi.
No matter what, in my lifetime, I'm going to space.
Just 26 years old and newly engaged. Stefan Günther, a German pilot and father of three.
I want to go there. I'm willing to pay the price.
And Suan Pien.
I do feel like it's my destiny to colonize Mars.
Tech worker from California.
I think I would be completely crushed if I found out I didn't make it.
These three hopefuls are competing to make the cut for the next Mars One selection round. Only 100 potential astronauts will be chosen. They'll find out any day now. The first launch date is set for 2024.
I've told so many people about this story. And the reaction that I get almost every time is, are you crazy?
We're already doing this, so accept the new reality.
We met Bas Lansdorf, the 38-year-old CEO of Mars One, his small office outside of Amsterdam. Slick videos, he and his team of space experts claim they can do what NASA so far has not.
The humans will leave Earth, arriving on Mars, April 2023.
An entrepreneur by trade, Lansdorf believes Mars One's multi-billion-dollar mission can be funded by selling TV rights to the reality show.
Literally, everybody on the globe will be watching, just like when Neil Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin landed on the moon.
How much of the science is missing? How many more advances are required to be able to make this happen?
The technology is existing, but of course you can't buy it at Walmart. So we're hiring the established aerospace companies from all over the world, but no new inventions are needed to implement our program.
But because they don't have the technology for the return journey, a permanent colony will be formed.
This is what butter would look like on Mars, similar to what chicken would look like on Mars. Also freeze-dried.
Is an irresistible opportunity for Kellie Gerardi.
I think either you get it or you don't. I would equate it almost to seeing Mount Everest for the first time. And either you feel a yearning to climb it or you don't. And if you don't, I don't know if that I could ever explain that to you.
As for her wedding planned later this year, well, Kellie is facing the prospect of a very long-distance relationship.
Everyone makes the joke to us till Mars do us part. They couldn't be more in love.